Before the doors open, Lori and Monty give a quick lesson on helping Southern brides assert themselves.
Making your own decision is part of growing up.
In the South, we have to respect our elders.
The bride doesn't need to be disrespectful, but she has to be firm.
We've got to empower her.
Yes. Yeah.
We get in the dressing room and say, honey, put on your big girl panties.
Yes.
Time to grow up.
With that in mind, consultant Melissa meets a small-town bride with an old-school posse.
Where's the bride?
Come here.
I'm Laura Charles. I'm 21 years old, and I came from Heflin, Alabama to be here. I'm marrying Todd Hill. We've been dating for about 2.5 years now. We're not really opposites, but I'm not as country as he is. But we get along really well.
Who have you brought with you today?
This is my cousin Emily, and my cousin Sarah, my cousin Katie, my Aunt Emily, my grandmother, and my future mother-in-law, Miss Frances.
Laura, do you have some ideas of what you're looking for?
I like the form-fitting.
Strapless?
Good. Yes.
It was up to me. Probably I'd have her lace up to the neck.
I'm sort of old-fashioned, you know, and I don't care too much for bare skin.
The bare skin, I think, needs to go to the beach.
I will not wear a dress from head to toe. I was thinking maybe backless.
Grandma, what do you see her in today?
Classic, simple, mm-hmm. Traditional.
She's more old-fashioned where mm-hmm. She wants to wear.
Between future mother-in-law and grandma, this bride is outgunned. What is your budget?
$2,000 or under.
Why don't you all come with me?
Seeking a dress that strikes the perfect balance between old-fashioned and fashion-forward, Melissa leads Laura and her entourage over to the racks.
Is there anything that is a little bit backless?
Absolutely.
This is pretty because it's sheer. It's very sheer.
I need something more lacy instead of strapless. I like the sleeves. It's got lace up at the top where the bare skin.
It's a good old Southern ball dress.
As Miss Frances settles on her own pick, Bride Laura and her grandmother lock horns in the racks.
I don't care for that.
But
I don't.
My grandmother is very bossy. When she talks, everybody listens.
Pop always said, you make good choices, wise decisions.
Treat other people as you would want to be treated.
You do it right the first time, and then you don't have any regrets.
Children should be seen, not heard.
That's what you do now.
Haste makes waste.
You never lick the same calf twice.
When a bride has two very opinionated matriarchs to please, I have no choice but to tackle their demands one at a time.
Well,
oh gosh.
And guess what? It's up to the neck.
Bride Laura's future mother-in-law has chosen a satin and lace ivory A-line ball gown.
Ta-da!
No. I hate it.
There's no way I could wear a dress that had sleeves.
It's a definite no.
I don't want to even go out in it, but I will.
No, you don't like it.
No. I hate it. I do. It's a no.
It has the sleeves like I like.
The bare skin is covered.
It's a zero.
Honey, that dress is so old-fashioned that it is practically prehistoric.
Of course, I know times has changed. And nobody liked this dress.
I have changed my mind.
I'm very happy that she's off of that dress because there's no way that I was going to walk down the aisle in that.
Let's get another dress.
Definitely.
Now that Bride Laura has the go-ahead to shed the sleeves, consultant Melissa heads back to the dressing room in an attempt to put the bride in a dress that isn't straight out of the Stone Age, an ivory lace fit and flare gown with a sweetheart neckline and a beaded belt.
Oh, my gosh. It's just exactly what I wanted. I definitely think I'd have to rate this one a 9.
Well, looky. Okay, what are we thinking?
I love this one. I love it. It's got all that I wanted. I wanted the sweetheart. I wanted the lace. I want everybody's opinion to be good, but my grandmother's opinion matters the most. What do you think?
I would say thumbs down.
I'm not sure that I can find anything nice to say about this dress.
Just a little too frou-frou for me.
I guess Grandma's forgot that saying, if you don't have anything nice to say, don't say anything at all.
not right.
I definitely respect my elders. That's a big thing for Southern girls. I don't want to disappoint her.
No.
In my world, the bride decides, and I'm going to put her in one of her picks.
Bride Laura's pick is a strapless lace satin fit and flare with beaded belt.
Oh, gosh, it's pretty too.
When I see myself in this dress, I can see myself walking down the aisle in it.
Scale of 1 to 10.
It's a 10. I am really excited to show them. I'm a little nervous.
Wow, what a pretty bride.
So what do you think?
I really like it. I love it, actually. I really like how it goes from the lace to the satin.
It's beautiful. It's beautiful.
It's good.
Good.
I like it.
One steel magnolia down, one to go. I think it's time to close the deal with Grandma.
Just want to turn around.
You can open up your eyes now.
Oh my gosh.
So you can see yourself getting married in this dress?
Oh, yes.
That is pretty, Laura.
It looks like you.
Scale 1 to 10?
12.
Whoa.
You just have to trust your instincts. And I instinctively feel this is the dress.
Are you saying yes to the dress?
Yes.
Yay! She's absolutely breathtaking in the dress.
It makes me so happy that everybody agrees with my decision.
Downstairs in fittings, a bride arrives to give her own final nod to her dream dress.
Are you Skipper?
Yes, I am.
My name is Skipper McInerney. I'm 26 years old. I'm from Lake Hartwell, Georgia, and I'm here for my first alterations fitting.
This is my mom, Sally.
Hey,
my dad,
Liz,
Michael.
How are you? Nice to meet you.
So when was the last time you saw your dress?
I think about 7 months ago. Want to make sure it fits beautifully.
Okay.
Because when I tried it on last time, the size was perfect.
So there's not a lot of leeway there.
My fiancé is Clancy Ballinger, and we met at the University of the South. I think it was pretty much an instant connection, and he didn't stand a chance when he met me, so.
Wow.
Wow. How does it fit?
Fits like a glove. It's perfect.
Oh, it's absolutely, it's beautiful.
I know.
It's a great dress. It looks great on you.
Oh, Dad, don't cry. Seeing myself in the dress today made it so real. I can't wait to see Clancy's reaction. It's so pretty.
And 7 weeks later, Bride Skipper is ready to walk down the aisle.
It's so beautiful. I love my dress. It's traditional. It's demure. It's beautiful. Sweet. Perfect. I love it.
I'm very excited to see Skipper in her dress. She has had me really excited and looking forward to this for a long time now.
I, Clarence, take you, Skipper, to be my wife.
With all that I am, I honor you.
I'm so happy. It's so surreal, so surreal. We are very excited to start our lives together.
I'm so happy with the way everything turned out. It was just perfect.